I wonder if there's any part of you that feels like we're not having an honest conversation about Michael Jackson, about the family, about the legacy, or is this appropriate that he was the king of pop? You've got to celebrate his life a little bit, certainly through the first public memorial, and then maybe there's a broader reexamination of who he is and what he did.
Well, I don't think we are having an honest conversation, because it goes between the sort of adulation of someone who died, someone with talent, raw genius talent, and someone who is a freak. And the bit of the conversation I find not honest is our role in this, because we kind of consumed this guy, we feasted on his talents and on the freak
show. Our role as the public or as the media?
As the public. Both. Okay. I mean, the media reflects what the public wants, okay? But we're all part of this. And here's a guy who was raised from childhood to be a commercial success. So if anyone was going to be able to deal with the fame, it should have been him. And in fact, it consumed him too. It consumed Elvis Presley. Can any human being deal with this kind of public attention? And why do we allow people, why do their families allow people to go to this kind of freak show zone where they don't have the support? Who allowed these doctors, the hangers-on, just as they were around Elvis Presley, to allow this guy to be in such a vulnerable position? So I think we kind of got to look at ourselves here and say, yeah, we enjoyed the fame, we enjoyed the freak show, but what does that do to the individuals, because they are human beings in the middle of it? Now, maybe feeling sympathy for Michael Jackson's controversial. You know, he obviously did a lot of things that were extremely questionable. But, you know, we have a role in that, too. We're not just passive consumers of this stuff.
Well, no two ways about that. And it's funny, as I look at the three of the cases that we're spending a lot of time on over the last week or so, look at Michael Jackson, look at Governor Mark Sanford in South Carolina, look at Bernie Madoff up here in New York, and I say all of these are extremely wealthy, powerful individuals who, in some ways you could argue, were getting away with stuff for a long time, which a number of people in their inner circle and even some outer circles knew what was going on. And now in the aftermath of it, we go, oh, we're surprised that after seven SEC investigations that Bernie Madoff was ripping people off to the tune of tens of billions. Oh, we're surprised that now that Mark Sanford holds a press conference and says, well, I crossed the line multiple times. That things, I don't know. I wonder whether there's a little bit of hypocrisy, as you said, on all of our parts who are watching this, consuming this, and now profess some kind of outrage when, come on, Michael was doing strange things when he started changing the skin color in the nose.
And hanging out with a chimpanzee. I mean, seriously. I mean, the warning signs were all there, and yet you set that aside because, look, we like feasting on it. It's like, why do people love car crashes and plane crashes? They do. They say that's horrific, but we're compelled to watch this stuff. And we've got to ask ourselves what kind of people we are, too.
You know, and I don't mean to be too much on a soapbox here, but one of the tough things about this is, even as we spend a lot of time on Michael Jackson, the reality is the economy seems to worsen. Mm-hmm. And not only that, in Afghanistan, we've got 21,000 new troops there, major new offensive, and there's some worry that that could become a bloody and protracted fight that at least one general told me could end up taking 7 to 15 more years.
Now that is worth talking about.
If we are covering the right amount, are we covering the right things? Are we being genuine in our coverage of not only celebrating his talent, but saying there are real accusations of pedophilia here, not once, but several times. There's questions about their kids that look white. You know, they look white to me.
Right.
And we've kind of all gone along and say, sure, they're his kids.
Right.
Right.
Well, and also, look, we're having this conversation. You heard Jermaine Jackson telling Matt Lauer, oh, this is what Michael wanted, you can see what his wishes were. Well, did anyone really understand what his wishes or intents were? If you did understand them, was it really comforting and settling, or was it actually really disturbing? So there are legitimate things to discuss. The question is, are we getting the tone right? I mean, this veering between the very respectful and the building him up and the freak thing, I don't think we've really settled. And maybe that's a sign of the fact that we don't really still know how to deal with Michael Jackson as a human being or as an icon.
Oh, Ari.